Hello and welcome to Excel is Simple. Today, we are going to create this simple Excel task tracker, which you can use to track all of your tasks in every category. Like here we have work, home, boss, finances, kids, wife, personal. And then as far as urgency is concerned, it can be important, not important, code red or maybe. From this task tracker, we will extract various dashboards, which include one for all pending tasks, wherein we have all the pending tasks in one place. Then we'll also have one dashboard wherein we can see pending tasks by category. You can just select the category from here and you'll see all the pending tasks over here. And then there's another dashboard which shows you pending tasks by urgency. Here you can just select the urgency and you'll get all the pending tasks. One more dashboard where you can select the task and you'll get all the details about the task, something like this. And then there will be one dashboard which shows you a summary of all the pending tasks by urgency and by category. I think if you follow all the steps in this particular video, you'll see that it'll not take you more than 15 minutes to make this particular tracker. I'll also drop a link in the description to download this tracker. So let's get started. So I opened up a new Excel sheet and let me call this particular tab as Master Tracker. And let's set all the headings that you want over here. The first one would be serial number, then the task. After that, the category, then the urgency, then you might want to add one column for task details, and then you leave one column for completed date. All right, so now let's start filling some data over here. The first thing is the serial number. Now you know that you want to start it with 1, 2, and so on. But here I want to add a function in serial number, which says that if the task is blank, then the serial number is also blank. Otherwise, it will be the previous one plus one. Let's put the function. Let me put the serial number one as is. And in serial number two, what I'll do is that equal to if len of B3, which is this particular cell, is equal to 0, then I should have a blank cell, else it will be the cell just above it plus 1, something like this. And you can see that as soon as I put some details over here, the number appears. All right, so now I have got a function in this particular cell. Let me just drag it down. Now as soon as I start adding tasks over here, the serial number is also appearing. The next thing is the category. You would want to define those categories as per your requirement. What you can do is that you can create a small table over here in a separate tab. Let me call this tab as tables. Now I need to add categories and I need to add urgency. So what I'll do is that I'll add two tables, one for categories and the other one for urgency. Now here I'll add all the different categories that I want. In this case, I have added work, home, boss, finances, kids, wife, and personal. Similarly, I'll also add the urgencies. Now here I have added important, not important, code red, and mayday. Now what I'll do is that I'll go back to the master tracker tab and add data validations. So I'll go to category here. Let me go to the first cell, which is C2, data validation, list. And in this list, I will click on the source and without clicking anywhere else, I'll go to tables and you'll see that the tables by itself comes over here in source. I'll just select all the different categories like this and then press an OK. And you'll see that this categories has got now a drop down list which has all the different categories that I'd mentioned in the tables. Similarly, I'll go to urgency and here again, I'll go to data validation list. On source, I'll go to tables. And from the urgency, I'll select all the different urgency values that are possible and press OK. Here in urgency, I have a dropdown that lists all the different urgencies. So now I have got category dropdown. I got the urgency dropdown as well. Now the first thing that we'll do is that we'll go ahead and freeze the first row view, freeze top row. Once this is done, we'll also kind of make the headings bold and then we'll just format this one a bit. And then we'll just add some borders to the task tracker. Something like this. One important thing to do is that once you're done with your formatting, make sure to add a named range to this particular table. So how do we add a named list? You just select all the columns like this. Go over here where you see A1 and add a name to this particular range. Let's call it task list. Here. Now I'm going to add some dummy tasks over here so that making this particular tracker and the dashboard becomes easier. Here I have added some dummy tasks like this. And now let me also add completed dates to some of the tasks. Let's say something like this. So now in a way your task tracker is ready. I mean, creating a task tracker is very easy, but the most important thing is that how are you going to visualize it? How are you going to see which tasks are pending and how important they are? And now let's create all the different dashboards that we want. So now the first dashboard will be for all pending tasks. Let me open up a different tab and call it all pending tasks. Now there are two approaches to creating this particular pending task dashboard. One is that you use a pivot table and then add different filters that give you the pending tasks. But there are two issues with the pivot table that I have seen personally. One is that you need to keep refreshing it, and the other one is that a lot of times it tends to increase the size of your sheet. So we are going to use the filter function here. What the filter function will do is that it will create an array with different filters that you want. Now, if you remember, we created a named range called task list. So let's use that particular task list array only to create that filtered list. So now let me just start creating this particular filtered array over here. What I'm going to do is that somewhere here, I'll put the function equal to filter bracket start. I'll start typing the named range task list. And you'll see that it appears below over here. Double click on it, comma. And now I need to select the inclusion criteria. So what are my inclusion criteria? Let me go back to the master tracker and see. I've got two inclusion criteria. One inclusion criteria is that my serial number, this particular column A, it should be non-blank and the completed date should be blank. So let me approach this one by one. Here, let me select the entire column A. And then I say over here in the function that this one is not equal to zero. How do you represent not equal to? With a less than and greater than zero. Note that in the filter function, if you have to use multiple inclusion criteria, those criterion should be separated by an asterisk. So what I'll do is that I'll put the first inclusion criteria inside a parenthesis, then add an asterisk, and then another parenthesis start, and select the column for completed date, which is column F, and then this one I'll put equal to zero, parent close, again parent close, and press enter. Now here you can see that I now have a list with all the pending tasks. This is your dashboard for pending tasks. Let me just adjust the cell widths, something like this. And then I can use the same headings in the master tracker over here as well. Here you go. Now you can see that as default, this particular filtered list is coming as per the serial number sequence. What if you want to put it in the sequence of, let's say, the category? We'll put this entire filter function inside a sort function. See, I'll put down sort bracket start this entire function, and then I'll put, let's say I want to sort it by categories, which is column number 1, 2, 3. So it will be comma 3 bracket close and enter. Here you go. You can see that this particular table is sorted by category in the ascending order. You can add a heading over here, all pending tasks. You might just want to hide this particular column because it's got no relevance over here. Page layout, remove the grid lines. So here is your list of all pending tasks. Now you can see here that it's still showing a huge list with all the zeros over here. Why is this happening? The reason for it is that we have selected master tracker AA, which is this particular column, as not equal to zero. But our function is also taking into consideration all the different cells that have got functions. So literally a function is not equal to zero. But what we can do is that we can, instead of the direct value, we can put this particular column inside a len function, which will check for the actual value of the column. So if I do len of master tracker AA and then put it inside a parenthesis and then press enter, you'll see that all the different numbers are gone. Now you might also want to put borders on all the cells that have got values in them. So we can put a conditional formatting over here. Just select any particular cell, go to conditional formatting, manage rules, new rules, and then go to classic. From here you can select only format cells that contain, and here you select no blanks. Then go to customized format, don't select anything else, just the border, and select an outline over here like this and press OK and OK. Now you can see that this particular cell has got a border. Select the format of this particular cell, and now if you paste it like this, you'll see that only the cells that have got data in them will have the borders. Now as and when the number of rows gets lesser or greater, these borders will also be added automatically. Now next I want to add a dashboard which shows pending tasks by category. So let me just add another tab over here. Alright, now I'll go over here and start adding a filtered list. But before adding a filtered list, what I'll do is that I'll add the category drop down over here. So I'll go to data, data validation, list, click on source, go back to tables and select all the categories over here and then press OK. So I have the categories drop down over here. And here I'll add select category like this. Now here what I'll do is that I'll add from the master tracker a filtered list which shows me completed date is blank and the category is the one that is selected over here. So first what I'll do is that I'll just select any random category over here. Let's say it's home and then I'll do equal to filter. The array would be task list, comma, inclusion criteria 1 is my completed date, which is this one is equal to 0. But then I know that I have two inclusion criteria. So the first inclusion criteria I'll put inside a bracket, add an asterisk. And the second inclusion criteria is that the category, which is this one, this again will get inside a bracket, is equal to the category that I've selected over here, which is this one. Bracket close and enter. So here we have the filtered list for all the category home tasks that are pending. I'll just adjust the column widths over here like this. And let me just add the headings as well. So here you go. Now let me just test it by selecting a different category. See, we are now getting the pending tasks in work, finances. Here we have all the pending tasks in finances and so on. Now, similar to what we did earlier, let's just add some conditional formatting over here. Select one cell, go to home, conditional formatting, new rule, go to classic, and from here select only format cells that contain, and here it's non-blank. Customized format, outline, and okay, okay. Select this format and paste it in the array till certain rows, something like this. Go to page layout and remove the grid lines, and then let's check with different categories. Let me select finances and you can see that the borders are also appearing as and when the number of rows are increasing or decreasing. Alright, now you can also hide this particular column which is not needed. Alright, I think you would have understood by now how to create pending tasks by urgency. In order to do that, let me simply do one thing, that let me just replicate this particular sheet and make changes to it. How can we do that? Go to the tab name, right click on it, and then move or copy, create a copy, and we'll just put it before this particular sheet, tables, and okay. Now you get pending tasks by category 2. I'll call it pending task by urgency. Now the first thing that I'll do is that I'll just change the heading over here, call it select urgency, and change the data validation. Data validation, list, remove this list and instead select the urgency list and press OK. I'll see that as soon as I select something over here, it'll show me an error. This is because now I have to change the filter list as well. So when I press over here, I can see that the filter list is showing me the master tracker FF is not equal to 0 and master tracker column C pending by urgency B3. Now this is something that I'll change. Instead of column C, I need to see in my master tracker where is urgency. Click over here, urgency is column D. So I'll go back to pending tasks by urgency, double click here, and then instead of C colon C, I'll type D colon D and enter. So you can see how easily the dashboard for pending tasks by urgency has been created. You can test it by selecting different urgencies. Let's say it's code red, and then if I have mayday, not important, and important. Now let's create one tab which shows you the details of individual tasks in one place. So let me just add another tab over here and call it task details. I'll give the user an option to enter the serial number. Let's say as default I'm adding 1. Now I'll copy all the header information from the master tracker and paste it over here. And using a simple VLOOKUP, I'll get all the task details over here. So the serial number would be equal to this one that is selected over here. Task would be equal to VLOOKUP of the lookup value, which is serial number, comma, the table array is task list, comma, column index number is 2, comma, 0. And now I can just copy this particular function and keep increasing the column index number in each and every upcoming cell. Then I can have these headers pasted in a transposed fashion like this and have all the information appear over here. Now what I'm going to do is that instead of completed date, I'm just going to put down whether it's completed or not. So I'll call it task completed. And here I'll put a function equal to, if the completed date is greater than 0, then it's completed, else it's work in progress. I can check this by changing the serial number. All right, now you can start formatting it a bit. All right, now this might not look so useful in the current view, but imagine that your master tracker has got 10 to 15 columns in which you're entering data. Then in that case, this task details tab is going to be very helpful to visualize what is the different information in each and every task. So we now have one dashboard for all pending tasks, one for pending tasks by category, one for pending tasks by urgency, and then the task details. Now the last thing that we want to add is a summary. In this particular summary, we'll just have the total number of tasks that are pending by each category and by each urgency. So let's make that one as well. So what I'll do is that I'll just add a tab over here and call it summary. In the column, I'm going to put down the different categories. Let me call it categories, and I'll put down all the categories over here, paste it over here, and then in these columns I'm going to put down the urgencies. Go to the tables, copy all the urgencies from here, go back to summary in this particular cell, right click, paste special and transpose. Okay, now that you edit the categories and the urgencies, what you want in each of these cells is that it should give you the number of tasks pending from the category and the urgency. Like in this first cell, what you should get is the number of tasks pending for work that are important. You might also want to shuffle the urgencies based on how you want to look at it. Like in the first column, you would want code red or possibly mayday, then code red, important, and then not important. So let us shuffle them accordingly. So now in order to find those pending tasks, we will use a countifs function equal to countifs criteria range 1. For that, we'll choose category. We'll go to all pending tasks tab. Click over here, select the category tab, which is D, comma. Go back to the summary tab and select work, comma. Your criteria range 2 is the urgency. So we'll go back to all pending tasks and select urgency, which is column E. Put a comma, go back to summary and select this particular cell, mayday. Bracket close and enter. Now you can go ahead and start doing this for each and every cell, or else a better way would be to look at how you can freeze certain references. Let's start doing that. Now in this particular cell, you can see that it's all pending tasks DD. Now the column D is for the category. We can just freeze it by putting dollars in front of D colon D. And C7 is this particular cell. Now we know that as and when this cell moves, your column will not change, but the row number will change. So we're going to put a dollar in front of the column and leave the row as is. So it will be $C7. Then all pending tasks EE. Now EE is for the urgency. So here again, we'll put a dollar in front of E and E. D6, which is this particular cell, we know that as and when the cells move, your row will not change. It will always be 6, but the column will change. D, E, F, G. So we'll put a dollar in front of 6 to freeze it and leave D as is, so that as and when the cell moves, the column reference also changes. So it becomes D$6 and then enter. Once you've done all the referencing properly, simply copy this particular cell and paste it in the entire array. Now this should give you the pending tasks by category and by the urgency. Just add some totals to the rows and the columns, and then add some formatting to this dashboard as you would want. So now this will give you a pending task summary with all the tasks that are pending by category and by urgency. So now you saw how simple it was to create this Excel task tracker. You have all the tasks in one place. You can sort them by category, by urgency, and you can also look at the different task details and have a summary for it. A link to download this particular sheet is available in the description. So go ahead and download it. And make sure to like this particular video, and if you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel to get notified every time a new video is uploaded. And that was the video, guys. Until next time, bye-bye.